Beauty and the Beast came about when Mark Pedowitz had this great idea to use this title and reboot the 80s show with Linda Hamilton. And CBS brought it to my writing partner and myself. All we had was a title, and they said, it's about beauty and beast can be whatever your definition of beast is. He could be an animal, he could be a serial killer. It's yours to interpret. And the two of us looked at each other, because we're not genre writers, and we thought, we don't know what to do with this Beauty and the Beast. But we could see the poster, which was, what woman doesn't like a guy with a little baggage, or who doesn't like a bad boy? And we started talking about the themes of what's beauty, what's considered beastly in our society and our culture today. And that's sort of how it came about. And we just started talking about a grounded medical experiment, and our beast became the beast you see in the show.
Everyone told me it was a wild animal, that this thing I thought I'd seen was just the result of my concussion. I believed them. Until now.
Each episode will be able to stand on its own because there's this procedural element to them. And so there's always going to be a good case of the week. But it will be serialized in that Vincent and Catherine's relationship will grow and, you know, of course, face incredible obstacles. And there's going to be a great love triangle. And we're going to uncover what is this Muirfield medical experiment that created Vincent and killed Catherine's mother. So some of it's going to be serialized, but be able to come in at any point and watch an episode and enjoy it.
Tell me about yourself. What happened to you?
After I lost both my brothers in the towers, I enlisted in the service. I had the chance to make a difference. All I know is that they changed our DNA. They made us stronger, faster. They couldn't control us, so they gave orders to eradicate us all.
You've just been hiding out here?
Yeah.
Except you go out there and you save people.
Guess it reminds me of who I used to be.
A doctor.
Human.
We're trying to reach 18 to 50 in my mind. 18 to 34, because you have these great female characters, Tess and Catherine at the center, who are at their heart, they're just two women trying to make it young, and they're young in their careers starting out. And I feel like what young woman watching TV doesn't want to see that? I mean, it's like Friends, but they have jobs. So there's that, but you know, the moms and can watch it as well, because you know, these are women who have careers and have lives, and we're gonna have this procedural element, and then Catherine's gonna go and deal with her personal life. And in that way that we all sort of juggle both our careers and our personal lives. Hopefully it'll do both, and who doesn't like a good case to solve and then this great romance? I think that's timeless. I think Vincent is an incredibly compelling character. He's got this incredible military backstory that we're going to be exploring. And there's a ton of action. And Catherine and Vincent are going to be saving each other. They both can kick butt in their own ways. I mean, she's not bad to look at for the guys. But, I mean, she's a great, strong female character. And he's this incredibly compelling hero, in a way. He's like an anti-superhero. He's not trying to save the world because of what's justice. He's just trying to cling to his humanity. But, you know, what guy isn't going to want to root sort of for this underdog?
I just found six cases of you trying to save victims around the city. You're not a monster. You're like a superhero.
It's a little bit of a Romeo and Juliet. Action is international appeal. I think this has appeal for everyone. We were filming, and every day we'd be on the set and say, wow, there's a medical component to this, because we would be in the medical examiner's office space and hear about the cool medical stuff involved. And then we were in the precinct and realizing, wow, no, it's also a crime show. And then we're in the warehouse and watching this timeless romance. And it doesn't matter where you're from. Who doesn't want a forbidden romance? We feel like we won the lottery in terms of our time slot on the schedule. Because we're following, you know, the highly viewed Vampire Diaries. And this, too, is a tale about forbidden romance, delicious affairs, as Mark Pedowitz called it. But we're just also going to have this added procedural component, which maybe will attract older and younger audience, because we also are going to have a case of the week. But it feels like a perfect pairing.
Ah. This is Agent McClary, FBI.
Hi, this is Detective Catherine Chandler, NYPD.
I have a weird DNA sample that could relate to my mother's murder case.
Agent McClary, I appreciate you doing this.
Well, CW's already done such an amazing job of launching all these multi-platform marketing campaigns, viewing experiences. We've talked about maybe having like a comic book spin-off that would start online somehow. We'll probably be doing Twitter and Facebook. We're on Facebook, leaking little bits in here and there about what could happen next. It's going to be a lot of twists and turns and bombshells, and we hope to keep it really exciting and adrenalized. And we're thinking this is Twilight meets X-Files.